Hey guys, we are so happy to be back with you today on this day 8 of the 12 Days of Questions on our Redeem Marriage podcast. We do these in one take always, but this is take 3 because I'm not a very good introductor. But we had a great question.
Nor can she read.
I was having trouble reading. It's fine. But we had a great question from Atlanta, Georgia. And it says this: I have a question and it's about triggers. Do you have any stock phrases that are helpful when you or your spouse bumps up against something that triggers a deep wound? I think our tendency is to shut down if the spouse that's been hurt is triggered. What is something helpful they can say that will reach out and not cause conflict? And then what is something helpful that can be a positive response that will spur on communication?
Okay.
That was a hard one. I'm glad you're doing this one.
Well, I have lots of thoughts on this one. So first of all, let's just get straight what a trigger is. Mm-hmm. So you've probably heard, and you are probably familiar, but if you're not, a trigger is basically something that when one of your senses, it could be any sense. It could be you see something, you hear something, even smell, touch, taste, whatever. But it triggers a deep wound somewhere inside of you. Now, it doesn't necessarily have to be a deep wound, but that's where we're going to go with this, is just to address those deep wounds, because we have a lot of those. And so the reason why I think that it's probably best that I take this is because there are a lot of triggers in my life. And so if you're not real familiar with our story, or you've just joined us recently and you don't really know everything, a little over 9 years ago, Heather was unfaithful in our marriage. And so because of that, there are lots of triggers. And basically what I mean by that, just to give some examples, we may drive by somewhere that reminds me of something that happened. I see someone in the community that just was a part of the story, and that may trigger something. But it can even be really small things that you don't even expect. Even like from time to time, looking at your spouse, and maybe you're like scrolling and just messing around on your phone or something, and just, something that happens a million times a day, but it's just all of a sudden you think, there was some stuff going on, that would cause me to think about that. So anyway, there's just triggers that happen. And so when a wound happens, those triggers early on happen very often. Like, not even, I can't even say daily, because for the first little bit, it wasn't even, it was like hourly or even more frequent than that. And so these triggers happen, and over time they get better, but it doesn't matter. 9 years later and they still pop back up. So I want to just address a little bit about how you can respond to that and how you can process that. And I'll kind of talk about it from both sides, from both spouses' point of view. So first of all, I think that there's two ways that we react. First of all, there's an internal reaction to the triggers. And so what I mean by that is that when a trigger happens, you immediately on the inside need to begin to process what it is. And I would say that probably every time a trigger happens, it could just be in normal everyday life, but Satan gets his hooks in at that point, and he starts trying to convince you, it's all your fault, you aren't good enough. And I'm speaking obviously for our specific situation, but there's all kinds of triggers that happen, and they don't have to be as big as an affair. But those things start thinking through all that, and it can just get you deeper and deeper. And you even start thinking, it doesn't matter. Even if you've come so far in your relationship, it's attacking all of a sudden on your spouse again. And so to be able to internally process that, I think that a great thing to do is to begin to speak truth to yourself. And so, you know, that can be scripture that you've memorized or just phrases, like you said. I mean, Heather has a tattoo that says daughter of the king. I mean, what a perfect thing to say, you know, when you see that trigger. That's not something that I'm going to go and bury myself in, because I know the truth. I know that I'm a daughter of the king. I know that I'm a son of the king. Or maybe it's a scripture, you know, no weapon formed against me is going to prosper. You know, anything like that, that just is. I remember when you were going through cancer, you had a truth jar, mm-hmm. and there were scriptures and things that would remind you. So you could just reach in and take one and just read truth. And so I think that internally, that's the first step, is processing that with truth, because they're going to happen. Just be prepared and know that they're going to happen. But then there's this external processing. And so usually what happens when you see a trigger, the initial reaction is to shut down. Mm-hmm. And that's what that question said. Mm-hmm. And I mean, that's the initial, that's just kind of the generic way of handling it is that, because the alternative to that is emotional blow up, you know, getting into an argument, mm-hmm. fighting with your spouse, whatever it is. And so it does become this shutdown. Mm-hmm. So what I want to do first is I want to talk about what the spouse's reaction to that can be, because usually the way it happens is a trigger happens, a spouse shuts down, the other one says, "What's wrong?" And then you get into this, "Oh, nothing." You know, and there's some reasons for that. We can talk about that in a second, but there's a reason that, you know, I don't want to hurt them. I don't want to say anything, or gosh, I'm just being silly again. I don't want to say something. And no, I know something's wrong. What's wrong? And then you know what happens at that point. So a great way to handle something like this, I think, is that if there's been a trigger that's opened up a deep wound, admit it. Like, it's okay to say, "Hey, you know what? Something that just happened, it reminded me of a deep wound." It may not even have anything to do with your spouse. It may be a wound of something else. Mm-hmm. But it opened up this deep wound, and I just need a little space to process that. Mm-hmm. Like, that's okay to ask for that. Mm-hmm. And then the response of your spouse needs to be, "Okay, you know, I'll give you that space." But there's also an opportunity to really validate that hurt. Mm-hmm. And I think that that's important, because, you know, I told Heather early on, I said, you know, I was never going to be one to hang this over her head, and I have not done that. But I don't get tired of hearing her say, "I'm really sorry that I hurt you." I mean, even 9 years later, I don't want her to come up to me every other day and say, "I'm really sorry about this," because that opens up wounds. But if she knows that I'm hurting because of a trigger, for her to be able to say, "You know, I'm really sorry, because I know that I caused that wound." And then to be able to say, "Look, I'm happy to give you your space, but if you need to talk through this, or if you need me to help or answer any questions in any way, please know that I'm here." And that's good enough. Like, that's good enough. You don't have to. But the worst response is, "Oh, why do you always bring this back up? Or can you not just get over this?" No. I mean, there are wounds that are so deep that, yes, we still process through those things. Mm-hmm. And so the other part of the whole external thing that I would say would be from my point, and the question that I would ask yourself if you're being triggered and it's causing emotional shutdowns or blow-ups or whatever, what's the motivation? Like, what's the motivation for shutting down? Because if the motivation is, "I just need to take a breath, because I know that if I don't and I don't process this internally, then something, you know, a big blow up could happen," or whatever, that's okay. Mm-hmm. That's going to happen. But if it's because, "You know what? I want to hang this over her head. I'm hurting, so I want her to hurt too, or I want him to hurt, or I want somebody else to hurt, even if it doesn't have anything to do with him, somebody else needs to sit in this pain with me." Mm-hmm. And if that's the case, that's not good, and that's right. Not right. And so, you know, to recognize that the triggers are going to come, the triggers are okay, but I will tell you this, this is the last thing I'm going to say, but if you can learn to twist those triggers into almost being a moment of praise and thanksgiving, because when those triggers happen, Satan wants you to remember all of the awful things. But what God wants you to remember is how far He's brought you. That's right. Or even if He's in the midst of bringing you out of that, how much He's working, or even the hope of what could be or what can be in the future. And so those are the things that you take, and instead of making that trigger remind you of all those things, you stop and you go, oh my goodness, you know, I'm thankful that I'm not there anymore, and I'm thankful that I'm moving in this direction. So there's just ways to make it into a thankful praise. And so triggers are real. I know I talk the whole time,
that's fine.
But if you have anything that you want to add, you can.
I love that you said that it can be for both, because I have triggers in a different way.
Sure.
I have triggers more of, I can't believe I hurt him. And then also the reason why I have the tattoo, Daughter of the King, is because that's a big trigger for me in that I'm not worthy. That's what Satan attacks me with, that I'm not worthy. I don't deserve to be forgiven. I'll never be good enough for you. All of those things. And I love to have truth and lie cards. And those can be used for triggers. If there is a trigger for you that is a lie from the enemy, you write it down on a card what that lie is. And then on the other side, you cover it up with truth. And so anytime the enemy's attacking you with a lie, you are able to turn it over and read truth about that. And truth is what comes from Scripture. Not your opinion, not somebody else's opinion, not what a theologian said, but it's Scripture. It is what God tells you about that thing. And so I call those, and that actually comes from my mentor, the truth and lie cards. And I have lots of them. I have lots that I pull out often, and then I have some that were for a season. But yeah, when you started off with preaching truth to yourself and waking up every day and doing that, reminding yourself who you are in Christ, that's huge.
And part of the reason why we mention that is because we've said it's not your spouse's job to fix.
That's right.
Even if they've done something that's caused that deep wound, you have to get to a point in healing that you're not depending on your spouse to try to fix whatever it is. And so, yeah, I mean, just to be able to take that step back and process things internally, also knowing that it could come out externally, and you both have to communicate in that situation. But those are just, I think, great tools to be able to help with those triggers. And look, I mean, in all seriousness, I really feel like I have dealt with this and battled with this for over 9 years, and probably in a pretty healthy place with that. So if anybody has any specific questions about that, feel free to reach out. More than happy to help with that. But hey, I know it was a little bit deeper subject today, but great question, and thanks. And look, we've enjoyed doing this, and like, we were at the grocery a while ago, somebody we ran into, you know, from across the thing, just hollered at us and said, I love watching you guys. And I mean, just so thankful for people that and their encouragement. And so we'll keep doing this, and like we've said, if we reach one marriage and it helps them, then we're happy to do it. It's enough. So come back tomorrow for, what is it, day nine tomorrow?
Nine.
Day nine tomorrow. We'll see you then.